Hello YouTube and welcome to the second video about the world of Raja. If you liked the first video about the popful fruit, then you will enjoy this one as well. Because in this video we will deep dive into the world of the plants of the Nervurian jungles, which means that we will get to know some breathtaking and fantastic trees, crops, mushrooms and shrubs. But first of all, I have to say thanks to all of you guys who are now with us on this journey, and thanks to almost 200 subscribers and every single person who has watched my first video. So if you are interested in this project, the world we are creating right now, and the things that we will release in the next weeks and months, please subscribe to our channel if you haven't done yet, because it is free but helps us a lot, and you won't miss any videos in the future, like the next one where we will introduce you to some animals and the wildlife of the jungles. And also, if you don't like the content, you can still unsubscribe. But anyway, have fun with the video. Let's start with the most essential plants for the Nervurian population, the crops that are used for farming. Since the Nervurian Empire is home to many citizens, it also requires an enormous amount of food. One might think that the Empire's most important resource for their conquest would be a unique and rare metal, a special weapon, or any other kind of military technology. But it's much simpler than that, because the so-called Tulur is considered as the most critical factor in the military machine of the Nervurian Empire. And because of its resistance to parasites and its very nutritious fruits, it is an essential part of the Empire's food supply. Only the so-called Vares plant can compete with the famous Tulur, because the Vares is in no way inferior to the Tulur, but it requires more intensive care and it can only reach its true potential under the supervision of a well-educated and experienced farmer. That is also the reason why the Vares is usually only consumed by the nobility and is only cultivated by farmers subject to one of the wealthier lords. So before we move on and start with the trees and all the other plants, I have to be honest with you, because I haven't thought of every plant's name yet. So here's the challenge for you. If you come up with a name for a plant species, please comment down below with the timestamp and obviously the plant's name, and maybe we will come up with some funny and exciting names together. So let's move on with the trees. In total, we created 10 of them and invented some unique features that we will explore right now. Starting with this tree here. It is between 2 to 3 meters high and is mainly known for its scaly bark. And this bark helps to avoid the continuous growth of moss, which is a common problem in the rainforest. The tree is known for its shiny leaves, which make sure that rain falls off quickly, and also for its white blossoms as well as its reddish purple fruit. The fruit is often served as a sweet snack or dessert, and if you grind the blossoms and combine them with some animal fats, you will get an ointment which is often used as medicine against fever and headaches. The next tree is about 10 times bigger than the previous one and is known for its partly transparent leaves. The origin of this type of leaves is still a mystery to the jungle. But the fruits of this tree are really scarce, because only a few adventurous people are willing to go that deep into the wilderness only to find the fruit. Because one thing you have to know, this tree grows only in the deepest parts of the jungle and is considered to be one of the rarest trees in Nervuria. Legends and myths tell stories about the incredible experiences that come with eating the fruit. Some people say that by eating the fruit, you can connect with the soul of the world. While we are already at rare trees, we can also talk directly about the spectral tree. This tree is a rarity and more a legend than something that really exists. It is also known as the king of trees because it towers far above all other trees, sometimes up to a height of 70 or 80 meters, which is believed to be the result of its unique ability to grow its seeds inside other trees and then feed on their nutrients. So the spectral tree is a kind of parasitic tree. And another unusual characteristic is a specific liquid that this tree regularly releases. This liquid reinforces its connection to the host tree and attracts a certain kind of bird, which will carry its fruit far into all directions of the jungle. dead bird then places the seed of the tree on the top of another tree, and so the cycle of the parasitic king of the trees begins all over again. Almost outside of the jungles, near the massive Moss Mountains, you can often find the starwood tree. This tree conquers the hills, cliffs and ledges for itself and is rarely seen in combination with other trees. Because of its strange metabolism, which no one can explain, this tree not only absorbs light and transforms it into energy, but also stores a large amount of light. However, this special reserve isn't converted into energy, but instead radiated during the night and provides the base for its own ecosystem to a wide range of nocturnal animals and even several fungi. It is assumed that the excrements of these nocturnals are vital for the starwood tree. It is evident that the tree got its name because primitive people often confused the tree with a star at night. Some ancient scripts tell us about tribes and people who saw the tree as a sort of goddess, with the wood being an embodiment of the sun. And even today, the strange thing is that spears, arrows and bows made out of starwood are much more stable and durable than other types of wood. There are legends of ancient priests and monks armored with wooden battle staffs who were in no way inferior to soldiers with metal swords. Nowadays, starwood is sometimes gifted as a sign of good luck, but in some rural parts of the jungle, you might find an elderly man who begins a trance-like meditation, eating the fruit of the tree and then closing his eyes, sitting under the tree while a bonfire is burning, and then, after a while, he may find his last piece. The next tree is so small that it can almost no longer be called a tree. With its about 2 meters in height, it is challenging for it to get sunlight. Therefore, its branches extend very wide to catch every ray of sunlight possible. The trunk is also somewhat scaly due to the humid climate of the rainforest. The fruits of this tree are often and gladly eaten by the nobility as a wine-like drink. On Earth, these fruits are like a juicy grape. Therefore, it's not surprising that this tree is cultivated in the gardens of the rich and the beautiful. This tree is more of an average tree, with its height of about 12 to 20 meters. But not at all average is the golden resin, which is secreted from the trunk's center. The golden resin has strong luminous abilities underwater, which is why it is used for fishing and diving in the deep rivers and lakes of the jungle and also on the coastlines. The blossoms and the fruit of this tree are life-threatening poisonous and are used by certain groups to eliminate specific individuals. Yet, first medical research has managed to produce this poison in a weakened form as a kind of narcotic. Unfortunately, that narcotic has become a popular drug among the poorer people, which has recently led to many deaths. As you may have noticed, every tree is somehow unique and worth mentioning. Of course, there are a few hundred, if not thousand, normal trees, but because of the video's length, I only picked out the most exciting and important plants. So, this video doesn't claim to be a complete overview of an ecosystem of a whole biome. And so, the next tree is also very unique. For a long time, it wasn't clear whether this tree is a plant or an animal. The reason? This tree moves over the forest floor throughout its life, and no one knows exactly why it does it. Its fruit, however, is known as a delicious food, and when cooked, it gets a fleshy consistency. And after all, this was also a big reason for the confusion whether this tree is an animal or not. While we are talking about fleshy and unique fruits, this tree, which is about 30 meters high, is well known for its fruit, also called the blood fruit. It doesn't taste as good as what we have seen so far, but is known for its ability to heal wounds in humans and animals. If you press the fruit and let the juice simmer for a few hours, you get a drink that will strengthen your body. The traditional healers say that the wounds would heal from within, and it is not known what exactly is going on inside. Many insects and spiders inhabit this tree, so it's a hunting ground for several colorful bird species that feed on both the many insects and also the blossoms. Next to the king of trees, there's only one competitor when it comes to sheer size. Instead of branches, new trees grow from the parent tree, and it is assumed that there are not many individual trees in the jungle, but that they consist of several subtrees, and due to this fact, the roots of this tree species often extend over several hundred meters and give the illusion of an individual forest. Some Nauruan citizens consider these forests as a sacred place, and these places are often called shadow forests because not a single bit of sunlight reaches the forest floor. Many myths and legends take place in these shadow forests, but in reality, they are only a welcome hideaway for rebels, criminals, and all of their kind. The fruits are small blue balls with little spikes. They are known for their sticky texture and are used for medical purposes. The fruits are not edible but require a particular method before being used for medical purposes. The blossoms of this tree are often used as charms against bad luck and are considered holy by some women of the ancient families. The so-called shadow flower plays an important role in the mythology of the Nauruan religion, which would go beyond the scope of this video. Last but not least, I want to introduce the popful tree to you one more time. Here you can see it again in more detail, and the fruit itself is something you will surely know well enough already. Nevertheless, the vines and leaves should be inspected more closely here. Because of the long vines, moss coats are formed on the branches, and the fruits are very close to the trunk so that it can hold the weight of the vines and fruits. For this reason, the popful tree is also known for its thick, mighty trunk, which makes it difficult to chop down. As I mentioned before, you will see more trees in the upcoming videos, which I haven't listed here. As next, I would like to present to you two mushrooms, which are very special. This mushroom grows near rivers and lakes and is known as a side dish in soups and stews. It is said to be very nutritious and makes you feel relaxed and balanced. When eaten raw, this mushroom isn't directly deadly, but it can cause you to stay in bed for several weeks. Much more dangerous is this companion, which grows primarily on trees and replaces their bark. As a result, it infects the tree and enters into a parasitic bond with it. This mushroom is deadly, both raw and cooked. However, this mushroom is used in warfare in extreme cases to activate a berserker-like state among soldiers. For this, the mushroom is smoked, and the smoke has to be inhaled for many hours. The soldiers in this state appear to be in a fury and are known as Varekas, which means something like the fighting dead. It isn't uncommon for a soldier to suffer lifelong damage after using this warfare drug. One of the most interesting plants of the Nauruan jungles are the shrubs, because they are often used for medical or intoxicating purposes. Nevertheless, this shrub right here is considered the main drink by the Nauruan nobility because its red flowers can make a tasty tea that induces a state of alertness and great focus. Especially scholars and soldiers drink the so-called leraf in large amounts. It is comparable to a creamy tea, which has the effect of a supernatural strong coffee. Less spectacular but important is this shrub, which is very common and often considered the typical Nauruan plant. It is viewed as a sign of wealth and prosperity and marks the houses of wealthy citizens, lords and kings. Furthermore, the jungle roads of the Nauruan Empire are often decorated with these shrubs and serve as a directional sign. In a metaphorical sense, they are signs pointing the way to the Nauruan cities where prosperity and wealth await those who deserve it. To be honest, I never thought that I would ever think about the dental hygiene of a fictional culture. The leaves of this shrub do exactly that when you just chew on them long enough. When chewing, the teeth are cleaned by certain chemicals in the leaves and the sweetish taste emerges. And if you boil the roots of this shrub, you get a drink similar to a cough syrup. You can clearly see that this shrub isn't to be messed with. You shouldn't touch it, eat it, or anything else. The shrub emits a special spore that can cause confusion as well as hallucinations when you inhale it. This type of shrub is often found in the shadow forest I have already mentioned in this video. The last plant I would like to introduce to you today is the bell plant. This plant makes a bell-like sound when the wind passes by. It attracts small mammals as well as predators, and because of this it happens quite often that the prey's blood is spilled into the ground around a so-called bell field. This bell field gets most of its nutrients from the blood of prey animals hunted in the immediate surroundings. When a prey animal is just out of reach, the bell plant may grow for days towards the carcass or blood to absorb the nutrients. It is assumed that this shrub is a relative to the wandering tree we already discussed in this video. So this is the end of this video, and this was it for now about the flora of the Navurian rainforest. At the moment we are already working on video 3, in which we will introduce you to the wildlife and the ecosystems of the rainforest. So be curious, because we have already created over 100 fictional animal species. And if you like this video, please leave a comment and like, and I'm looking forward to seeing you again next time. Big thanks as always to Marshad, who created these beautiful illustrations, and as well to Leandro Notado, who helped with the concepts of both the plants and the animals. And of course there are so many people more that support me on Discord with all my ideas and concepts I have over the weeks. And if you want to chat on Discord about this project, you can join our Discord server that you find in the description below.